Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Michael Baltensperger. I'm a PhD student at the Zurich Graduate School of Economics, where I do research on economic history and public economics. And tonight, I'm very excited to talk to you very briefly about my research on how cantonal tax revenue sharing affects the economy. In Switzerland, as in many other countries around the world, not only the federal government, but also cantonal and local governments raise taxes. Cantonal taxes contribute significantly to important public goods, such as public schooling or public transportation. Decentralized taxation has many advantages. However, there is also a significant concern that it might lead to a race to the bottom, where cantons try to attract high-income taxpayers by lowering their tax rates. This competition can reduce overall tax revenue and leave cantonal governments with insufficient funds for their public goods and services. So why then, even though Switzerland is so decentralized when it comes to taxation, do we still have a great public schooling system and our trams and buses run on time? One answer to this question might be tax revenue sharing rules. Many countries around the world, especially federal countries, have such a rule in place. And in Switzerland, it is part of what we call nationaler Finanzausgleich. The tax revenue sharing rule mandates that cantons with a high tax base make transfers to cantons with a low tax base. In general, we do this because the first motivation for this is federal cohesion. We want that every canton, independent of the size of its tax base, can provide a minimum level of local public goods to its residents. Just as a quick reminder, a canton's tax base is the sum of income and wealth from which a canton can tax. Now, these cantonal tax revenue sharing rules also affect the economy. How so? To answer this question, we would need to know what happens in a world where we do not have these kind of transfers. Now, this is something that we do not observe. And this is why, in my research, I use economic theory and empirical methods to build a model that can answer the following questions. How does tax revenue sharing affect cantonal tax rates, aggregate output, and welfare of Swiss households? So far, we didn't have an integrated model that can answer these questions. This is where my research is making a difference. But before I talk to you about my results, I want to use this graph to explain a little bit more how the inter-cantonal tax revenue sharing rule actually works. Consider the black line in this graph. This is the graphical depiction of the intercantonal tax sharing rule. The dots are the position of the different cantons in the system. The horizontal axis shows the per capita tax base, and the vertical axis shows the transfers that cantons receive through this mechanism. I want you to note two things. First, transfers are determined by the size of a canton's tax base, not its actual tax revenue. And second, consider the dashed zero line. Cantons below this dashed zero line, they pay transfers, while cantons above this dashed zero line, they receive transfers. Now I want to highlight two important mechanisms. First, I want to explain how these tax revenue sharing rules affect cantonal tax rates. Consider a scenario where a canton, for example, the canton with the abbreviation SZ, the canton of Schwyz, lowers its tax rate while all other cantons maintain theirs unchanged. As Schwyz lowers its tax rates, additional taxpayers will move to Schwyz out from other cantons. This is good for the canton of Schwyz as this increases its tax base, which it can raise taxes from. However, in the spirit of this graph, the canton will also move to the right, and following the black line, it will move down. Therefore, we'll have to pay additional per capita transfers into this mechanism. This is how the tax revenue sharing rule dampens tax competition and helps preventing a race to the bottom. The second mechanism I want to highlight concerns aggregate output. Consider the cantons above the dashed zero line. These are the cantons that receive transfers. Now, with these transfers, cantons can either buy additional public goods for their residents, or they can lower their taxes. Both of these actions will make these cantons relatively more attractive places to be. And as they become more attractive, certain people and firms will decide they might be better to live in those places. Now, as people move, they change jobs, and as firms move, they change the structure of their production, and both of these things affect their productivity. This is why the tax revenue sharing rule can either increase or decrease overall efficiency in the economy, depending on how it relocates factors in the economy. Now, clearly, so these are the two points that I just covered. Now, clearly, the interesting question now is by how much the nationale Finanzausgleich affects all of these outcomes. This is why, in my research, I build a model that takes into account all of these mechanisms that I just explained. Let me start with the first result. What happens to cantonal tax rates? In this graph, I show you the current average cantonal tax rates, including municipal tax, for all cantons. The red dots are the results of my simulation. What you see here are cantonal tax rates in a world without the tax revenue sharing rule. My model predicts that the inter-cantonal tax revenue sharing rule increases cantonal tax rates on average by 3.5 percentage points. Now consider aggregate output. Again, the blue dots show the status quo, while the red dots show the situation without, or the world without, a tax revenue sharing rule. My model predicts that the tax revenue sharing rule reduces aggregate output by 0.5%. This is because the rule induces certain people to locate in places where they're less productive. Finally, my model also allows me to look at welfare. So I can look at how all of these effects impact the well-being of different types of households. What I find there is that lower-income households benefit from the tax revenue sharing rule. This is because the additional public goods that they consume overcompensate for the reduction in aggregate output. So what should you take away? Decentralized taxation has many advantages, but it also entails the risk of tax competition. Tax revenue sharing rules can dampen tax competition, but they also affect the real economy as they misallocate or as they reallocate resources in the economy. To study and quantify these effects, I construct a model that suggests that the nationale Finanzausgleich in Switzerland increases average cantonal tax rates by 3.5 percentage points on average, reduces aggregate output by 0.5%, and increases the welfare of lower-income households. Now, this is just a teaser of my results. Obviously, with this model at hand, I can study many more questions concerning decentralized taxation.